हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई एम प्रेम गुप्ता, योर इंग्लिश टीचर। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस यू आर डिस्कसिंग द लिटरेचर पोर्शन इन विच वी आर डिस्कसिंग द चैप्टर नंबर 2, दैट इज हाउ द डॉग फाउंड हिमसेल्फ अ न्यू मास्टर। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई हैव एक्सप्लेन दिस स्टोरी एज वेल एज आई हैव ऑल्सो कम्प्लीटेड द एक्सरसाइजेज गिवेन इन द बुक। Dear student, today we will discuss an important poem, that is The Kite. It is given in your book, that is composed by the Harry Vian, and it is given at the page number 27. Everyone just open page number 27. Today we will discuss the poem The Kite. Okay student, this is the poem in which the poet is describing a kite, about a kite, how it looks like in the sky. Okay, now just see the page number 27. All of us like to fly kite, we all know that we like to fly kite. And have you ever tried to fly one? And read this poem about a kite and its fly in the sky. In this poem, the poet is talking about, or poet is giving the description of a kite, that how it flies in the sky. Okay, student, just come to the poem. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. With a dive and a dip, a snap its tail, then soars like a ship with only a sail. As over tides of wind it rides, climb to the crest of a gust and pulls, then seems to rest as wind falls. When string goes slack, you wind it back and run until a new breeze blow and its wing fill, and up it goes. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. But a raggeder thing you never will see when it flap on a string in a top of a tree. Okay student, this is the poem. Now we will discuss one by one each lines in detail, and we will also explain the meaning or central idea of this poem. Okay student, now just see the poem. How bright on the blue. Yes students, here the blue refers to the sky. Here the word blue refers to the sky. It is written, how bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. Here the poet is giving the description of a kite, that when it is a new, then it looks very bright in the sky. Here it is written, how bright on the blue. Here blue refers to the sky, and kite when it's new. And when is a kite? When a kite is new, at that time it looks very bright in the sky when it flies. Okay? With a dives. Dives means, in Hindi we call gota lagana, jisko bolte hain, dives. With a dives and deep, it snaps its tail. And when with a dives, with a dives, when it dives, when we fly in the sky, it dives. And sometimes it dips and it snaps. Snaps, snaps means flutter, fluttering. It snaps its tail. And there is a kite, generally we also made in the kite, there is a tail. Suppose that this is the kite, and in the last we generally put the tail. So here, it snaps its tail. Snap, snap means fluttering. And when it is in the sky, and at that time it's fluttered its tail, then soars like a sea. Soars, soars means high flight, soars. S O
SARS. Source means high fly.
Just here. It snap its tail, then soars like a ship. It's as a ship. Ship जैसे आकाश में जहाज चलते हैं उसी तरह से क्या है यहाँ पे स्काइड भी चल रहा है. The soars like a ship with only a sail. Sail means here is a kind of we generally do sailing and while we generally sail to the boats. बोट को क्या करते हैं खेते हैं. इसी तरह क्या है काइट्स को भी वी आर ऑल्सो सेलिंग इन द स्काई. इट स्नैप इट्स टेल देन सोर्स लाइक ए शिप विथ ओनली अ सेल एंड विथ ओनली अ सेल इट कैन फ्लाई हाई इन द स्काई. एज ओवर टाइड्स टाइड्स मीन्स इट इज काइंड ऑफ स्ट्रीम. एज ओवर टाइड्स ऑफ विंड इट्स राइज एंड हियर द पोएट इज सेइंग काइट्स राइज हाई इन द एयर. व्हेन देयर इज अ विंड इन द एयर एट दैट टाइम द काइट फ्लाई वेरी हाई इन द एयर. इट एज ओवर द टाइड्स स्ट्रीम्स ऑफ विंड इट्स राइज एट दैट इन द स्काई. हु राइड्स द काइट द विंड राइड द काइट. ओके क्लाइम्स टू द क्रेस्ट. क्रेस्ट मीन्स एक्सेंट. एक्सेंट मीन्स चोटी. जैसे यार क्रेस्ट CREST क्रेस्ट. यार वेयर इज दैट वर्ड क्रेस्ट. CREST क्रेस्ट मीन्स एक्सेंट. ASCEND एक्सेंट मीन्स चोटी ऊंचाई. जैसे यार क्लाइम्स टू द क्रेस्ट ऑफ गस्ट एंड पोल्स एंड व्हेन इट फ्लाई इन द स्काई इट टचेस द हाईएस्ट पीक. हाईएस्ट पीक आर एक्सेंट आर क्रेस्ट ऑफ गस्ट एंड पोल्स एंड गस्ट. गस्ट मीन्स यार सडन स्ट्रॉन्ग रश ऑफ विंड. सडन स्ट्रॉन्ग विंड्स कम and then it pulls the kite. Then seem to rest as wind falls. And when the wind falls means here when the wind started blowing slowly, then what it shows at that time the kite seems as it is taking rest, as it is having rest. When the wind is blowing very fast at that time it fly very high in the sky. It touches the crest of any mountains. And when the wind is slow at that time it seems that it is also having rest. The kite is also having rest when the wind is slow. And when the wind is very high or blowing very fast at that time it touches the crest of a mountain. Okay, just see here. Climb to the crest of a gust and pulls, then seems to rest as wind falls. Here wind falls means slowly the winds blow slowly. Wind falls means the downfall of the wind. Okay, when a string goes slack. And string means thread. String means here thread. STRING string means thread. Okay, just see here. When string goes slack, slack means loose. Slack means loose. You can say slack means loose. When a string goes slack, you wind it back. And when a string is slack, when the threads of our kites are loose, then what we do? You wind it back. Then we wind it back. It means roll it back. And run until a new bridge bowl, a new bridge blows. And those who wants to fly the kite, they had to wait for the winds. Okay? Suppose if the wind is stopped, at that time the threads of our kites become loose. Or it's slack. Slack means here loose. When a string goes slack, you wind it back and run until a new bridge blows. And we wait for the new bridge for fly again the kite. And its wing fills up its goes. And its wings fill and up it goes means here the kite moves up with the help of the wind, with the help of the air only. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. Again the same line repeated, that is already given in the first two lines, that is how bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. And here the poet says that it looks very bright in the sky when the kite is new. Okay, it means here when the kite is new and when we fly it in the sky, it seems very bright, it looks very bright. And but a raggeder means torn or rough. Raggeder, it is very important word. Raggeder, means torn and rough, you can say. Okay, just see here. But a raggeder thinks you never will see. And sometime we also see that the kites torn. When? And when it torns, we do not like to see it. We do not prefer to fly the kite at that time. When it is in raggeder condition, when it is in torn and rough condition. And now, its flap on a string in the top of the tree. When its flap means flutter. When its flap on a string in the top of the tree. When it is stuck on a branches of a tree, then the kites flutter and flaps. At that time, the condition of the kite is very poor and it is torn and rough. At that time, we do not like to fly the kite. Okay, students, here in this poem, the poet says that the movement of the air, the movement of the wind decide the fate of a kite. Okay? A kite cannot fly its own. There is need of wind. Okay? Therefore, the fate of the kite is decided by the wind or the air. Okay, students? So, this is all about the poem that we have read. And you will also read this poem. Once again, if you have any kind of problem, you can ask. Okay? And now, just turn the pages, we will do the exercises which is given at the page number 28. Okay, just put out the pencil. Now we will see it here, working with the poem. Dear students, we have already completed working with the text, working with the language. Now we will working with the poem. This is the poem. In this poem, the poet has describe the quality of a kite and how it seems in the sky when it is new and what is requirement for flying a kite in high. What is it required? It requires the wind, it requires the air. Therefore, the fate of a kite will be decided by the wind. Okay? So, you will read this poem once again. And now come to the working with the poem. In the first question, list out the action word in the poem. Action word means doing word. Action word means doing word. That denotes the action, that denotes the work. And it is also called verb. Action word means verb. Doing word means verb. So here you have to find out the action word, verb from the poem. 2, 3 given here and rest you have to fill. Dive, that is action word. Dip, action word. Snap, action word. In such a way you have to find 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You have to fill the 5 action word in the blanks. Okay students, so here I am going to write just see. Okay, in the first you can feel there are 5 blanks. In the first blanks you can feel source, S-O-A-R-S. Okay, in the second action word, that is clients, C-L-I-M-B. All these words have come in your poem. Okay student, and these are the action words. Just see, source, clients. And there is one more, that is rides. That is rides. And this is the question number first. You will fill in your book. Source, climb, rides. And there are two more, pools. Pools. That is also action word. Falls. That is also an action word. Here. So you will fill these source, climbs, rides, pulls, and falls. These are the action word. Okay student, just write down these words in your book. And here just see, find out the meaning of these words. And dear student, you have to find out the meaning of these words. I think you all know the meaning of source. I have already told you. Climbs, you know, that is very simple. Rides, you know, riding anything. Pulls, khichna, and falls, that is falling down, to drop something. Okay students, so I think you all know the meaning of these words. Okay, source means I have already told you, that is fly high. Okay, so you write only the words and meaning. There is not enough space to write the meaning, so no need to write the meaning. You learn the meaning, but you learn it, you find out from the dictionary, from the any other resources. I have already told you. You keep in your mind the meaning of these words. Okay, source, climb, rise, pulls, and falls. Okay, so in this way we have completed the exercise number first. Now come to the second. The second exercise is read these lines from the poem. There are 2 lines given. Then source like a ship. Source means, I have told you, source means here fly high, like a ship. Ship refers to your aeroplane. Okay, then source like a ship with only a sail. With only a sail, एक बार अगर उसे खे देते हैं तो क्या करता है, चलता जाता है. If there is a only one winds, strong wind is there, then it's fly very high like a ship. Okay, here the poet uses the simile, the figure of speech. Okay students, when you go in the higher classes, you have to read the figure of speeches. Here just see, the movement of the tailless kite is compared to the ship. Here the kite is compared to the ship, and with a sail. This is called simile. It is already given here. This is called simile. Simile is a kind of figure of speech. There are so many figure of speech. Figure of speech means they are the ornaments of language. There are so many words for decorating, for managing, for making sublimity of that word. We use the figure of speech. Okay, students? So here, this is called simile. Can you suggest what are who following action may be compared to? There are some actions given and that you have to compare it with the other words by using simile. Here, dear student, I want to tell you that how do we recognize that this is simile? Generally, we find the like or as like. Okay? Where there we find, if we are getting any word in any sentence like as, it denotes the comparison. It shows the compare. Okay? As in your text, in your poem, it is already given source like a ship. Your source like a ship is compared. Okay? Your kite is compared with the ship. So here some action words are given. He runs like. You have to compare with an animal or anything that runs very fast. So here the word like is used. Where there you find the word like, as, you can very easily understand that the sentence, there are figure of speech, the simile is used. Okay? There is some comparisons are used in that sentence. So in this sentence, the poet has used source like a ship. There is a figure of a speech, that is simile. And you have to also make the, you have to also compare these action words with a noun or with anything. Okay? So now we will do this exercise. He runs like a. Dear students, the question number second, we will see. Just see here, question number second. Here we have to compare, we have to fill in the blanks. He runs like. It is already written. He runs like. Up to this it is written in your book. Okay? Up to this it is written. And we have to compare like a cheetah. Okay? Like a cheetah. Here we are comparing a person, he, to the cheetah. That he runs like a cheetah. Okay? Or we can also mention a tiger or lion. He runs like a tiger. He runs like a cheetah. Okay, students? So just write down this. Fill here. These words we have to fill. Just fill it. It is already given in your book. No need to write in your notebook. You only fill in the book. Okay? And again it retains, he eats. He eats like. Here you have to compare. He eats like an animal, you can say. He eats like a bird. Anything you can write to whom you want to compare. Okay? Just see. He eats like a bird. Okay? You can compare with a bird. That how he eats. He eats like a bird. It is a simile. Okay, students? She sings like. She sings like. In the question given, she sings like. She sings like. There are so many birds who sings very well, very sweet. So here, nightingale is famous for singing. So we will write here nightingale. She sings like a nightingale. Okay? Nightingale.
swims like a nightingale.
She sings like a nightingale. Okay. We have done three. He runs like a cheetah. He eats like a bird. She sings like a nightingale. Okay, nightingale is a bird. And it shines like a star.
It shines like, we have to compare it. What shines? Like a star. Okay, students, just write down. It shines like a star. Because star shines. Therefore, we are comparing the star with it. That it shines like a star.
Next, it flies like a.
It flies like a. We can write an aeroplane, or we can write an helicopter, or we can say it flies like a kite. Okay? So students, just fill it in your book. He runs like a cheetah. He eats like a bird. He sings like a nightingale. It sings like a, it shines like a star. It flies like a kite. Okay, students. So this is all about the exercise number second. And in the third exercise, try to make a kite with your friends. Here, there is an activity that you have to make a kite at your home. Okay, collect the things required, and you have to collect the things that is used for making the kite. Color paper, newspaper, thread, glue and thin stick that can be bent. After making the kite, if you can fly it, okay, so you will try to make the kite at your home. And you will also, before making the kite, you have to read this poem. Okay, you have to understand this poem and you have to complete these exercises. Okay, students, so this is all for today. In this way, we have completed the chapter number 2 of English literature, that is Honeysuckle. Okay, students, in the next class, we will discuss the next thing. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you.